and gold from your vain conversation received by the tradition of your father. So turn to someone and say, money has nothing to do with this. This is what we say. Our message has nothing to do with money. Now, a lot of them are preaching it. They're flying people in and spending the night in the church and then having preaching services thoroughly next month, the next morning. And then, of course, the preaching services are all designed to fleece money out of the people of God. And this is being done all over the country. There is no gospel being preached. There is no death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus Christ being preached. Consequently, no altar call is being made. No one is repenting because it is not being preached. And no one is being baptized in water in Jesus' name for the remission of sins. Nor are they being filled with the baptism of the Holy Spirit. But after the services have consummated, all one can say is that they raise a lot of money. And God is not, turn to someone and say, God is not in this. Well, of course, then we should have nothing to do with it. Then verse number 19, read, what about this? Verse 19, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, who was manifest in these last times for you, who by him do believe in God, that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in God. Because he turned to someone and say, because he is God. And this is why it was done by him, or done by God in Jesus Christ. Are you listening to me? Verse 19, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. Verse 20, I'm rereading it now in your hearing, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world. Now, of course, the earth began in the first day of creation. The world began when God placed Adam on the earth. This is why in the book of the Acts of the Apostles, I believe it is Peter who is preaching there, saying, God who spoke by the mouth of his prophets since the world began. That would mean the first prophet was, someone say, Adam. Someone say, Adam. And this is why the psalmist wrote, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. Let you know the world began when God put a man on it. The first man that God put on the earth was, someone say, Adam. So who verily was foreordained, Jesus Christ was foreordained before God put Adam on the earth of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you. Who was he manifest for? Turn to someone and say, for us. Who by him do believe in God that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in God, whose name is, I didn't hear you. Matthew chapter 20 and verse 28. Who by him, it is all done by him. In him we live and move and have our being. Peter said, even by him, though this man stand here before you whole, can the church say amen? So now in Matthew chapter 20, and in particular, we are interested in verse number 28. Well, let's read verses 27 and 28, even though verses 28 is where our thought be taken from. Let us read verse 27 and 28. If you have it, can we say amen? And let's read. And whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant. Even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister, and to give his life a ransom for many. And so now someone say redemption. This is the first work of the sonship. For him to give himself a sacrifice that he might give himself a ransom for many. Of course, then he would have to know exactly what God's expectation was in every detail. And of course, when he went to Calvary, that is, when Jesus Christ hung on Calvary, we gave you the 49 scriptures. Now, I'm not going through that tonight. We gave you approximately 49 scriptures that were fulfilled when Jesus hung on Calvary. The Bible class was taught. It is on tape. If you're interested in it, you pick it up, because we will not be revisiting that tonight. Can the church say amen? But, of course, some 49 scriptures were fulfilled when Jesus hung on Calvary in and of itself. And so this is how we know that he is not only the Son of God, but turn to someone and say, he's God manifest in flesh. The second work of the sonship, someone say mediation. This is that he is the mediator. Now let us go to Hebrews chapter 9, verses 15 and verses 24. This is the second work, the work of mediation. He is our mediator. Praise the Lord. I'm just going to have to give you a couple of scriptures on that. In Hebrews chapter 9, someone say Hebrews chapter 9, verses 15 and then verses number 24. This particular epistle of the 21 New Testament epistles is another one of the what is referred to as Pauline epistles. The Apostle Paul is, of course, considered by most theologians and historians to be the author of this book, even though he used what is referred to as Alexandrian Hebrew in his writing. A higher form, a Alexandrian Greek. It is said that it was the Koine Greek spoken in an area known as Alexandria, and that there's argument as to whether or not the Apostle Paul actually penned this himself. However, at the close of this particular book, you will find it is attributed to, written to the Hebrews from it to Timothy, written to the Hebrews from Italy by Timothy. But this is not the case, because Timothy was one of the Apostle Paul's company. And some have concluded that Paul dictated this particular epistle, and of course, Timothy assisted him in writing it down and carrying it to the churches. Be that as it may, turn to someone and say, be that as it may, it was inspired by the Holy Ghost. So it's still the word of God. Can the church say amen? In Hebrews chapter number 9, verses 15 and verse number 24, let us read. Let us start with verse 14. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, to purge your conscience from dead works, to serve the living God. Now, how did he do this? Turn to your neighbor and say, through the eternal Spirit. This means the eternal Spirit of God in Jesus Christ is the one that performed the work. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who, that is, Christ is the who, through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God. It was the eternal Spirit of God that carried the lamb sacrifice into heaven itself. And there in the office of the high priest presented the blood of the lamb, sat down on the throne, and became the God that received the blood of the lamb at the hands of the high priest. This was done through, someone say, through the eternal Spirit. I'm sure you know there is only one eternal Spirit. Can the church say amen? All right, now, what happened now? Verse number 15, read. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. Now this is a beautiful thing that he has written here concerning the work of God in Christ in bringing about mediation. And for this cause, he is the mediator. Someone say the mediator of